Now please welcome Chris Daughtry with his favorite band, Live.
My ammunition won't load into my gun. My inhibitions, they fall like the weight from a stone. You left my heart.
Chris Daughtry and Live. And now, friends, but which is which? I think that's the question. All right, now, friends, a lesson in culture for you. When we first met Kelly Pickler, she was a roller skating waitress at a cheeseburger joint in Albemarle. They obviously did not do much seafood there because trying to pronounce calamari almost gave her a brain hemorrhage. So we've given her some expert help. Please check out Puck and Pickler.
Hey there.
Hello, Kelly.
How are you?
How are you? I get the kiss from.
Wow.
That's a perfect appetizer, see?
Yeah, thanks. And it's not fattening either. Thank you so much for meeting with me today, I have to be honest with you. I've been a little embarrassed on the show because, you know, I didn't know what calamari was and a lot of people made fun of me. And so, you know, I'm going to be traveling the world and touring and I'm a little nervous about, you know, eating out and, you know, not knowing what I'm doing.
So you like to eat?
Please don't bring out anything that's still moving on the plate or has eyeballs, because I cannot eat food that is looking at me.
You can see the menu. I have to put my glasses on. That's a traditional menu with nothing outrageous on it, no nothing. It's written in English, too, you know, so you don't have to look that closely. Or you want my glasses?
Now, yeah, can I use them?
Okay. Now you look like a college professor.
Do I?
Yeah.
Do I look smart?
Yeah, completely.
Maybe people will take me seriously.
They will, completely.
Okay,
now.
Let's see.
It only has three words or four.
Escargot de la...
You're completely right. It's escargot a la bourguignon.
Oh, I heard that word the other day.
You know what that is?
No.
They pick up the little snails in the vineyards and then boil them.
You've got to be kidding me.
What do you mean, got to be kidding you? That's... In any French brasserie, you can see that.
I'm so sorry, but I really don't think I can eat that.
Look at that.
A snail?
Eat it now. You won't even know what it is.
I really don't want to.
Why?
Oh, that's creepy.
It's not creepy. What do you mean? A whole country, 50 million people, eat it all the time.
No, they don't.
Yeah.
No, they don't.
No, you never went there. What do you mean? I lived there.
Mmm.
Okay. Open. Mmm, look at that. The first time we had snail. Delicious.
That was really good.
Oh, you've become an actress.
Uh-huh.
Okay, can we have another order of snails, please?
You're going to make me sick.
I have to give you some traditional home cooking for you.
Absolutely.
Too. So you can go back home to, what is the town called?
Albemarle.
Albemarle? Albemarle.
Well done, Whoopi. All right, we're moving from snails and garlic to meatloaf on stage. The first two Bat Outta Hell albums sold over 45 million copies between them, and Bat Outta Hell 3 looks to be as big as the legend himself. Here to sing It's All Coming Back to Me Now, please welcome Catherine McPhee and Meatloaf.
There were nights when the wind was so cold that my body froze in bed if I just listened to it right outside the window.
There were days when the sun was so cool that all the tears turned to dust and I just knew my eyes were drying. I finished crying in the instant that you left, and I can't remember where or when or how, and I banished every memory you and I had ever made. Baby, 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 when you touch me like this,
give me all
you can give and forget, and it's all